Hello friends, in this video we will see the concept of global variable used in C programming. Let us first analyze this code and try to find out the output of the given program. I strongly recommend you to kindly pause the video and try to find out the output of the following program. Many of us must have written similar programs in the initial days of our programming, and we might not have got the correct answers. The program is quite simple, but why won't we get the correct answer in this case? Can you find out the reason? Well, the reason is that the local variable sum here has not been initialized to 0. In this case, it initially contains some garbage value, and when this garbage value gets added to I, the sum again is a garbage value. So our answer is something garbage which is not desired. So how can you overcome this problem? Well, we can simply overcome this problem by initializing the variable sum to 0. Let us now initialize the sum equal to 0 and find out the output of the program. Now we see that on initializing the sum equals to 0, we get the correct output as 55, which is the sum of first 10 natural numbers. So always remember to initialize the local variables to 0 in case you are adding some numbers to them, and initialize them to 1 if you are multiplying some numbers to them. However, if the sum is declared as global variable, then what would be the result? Can you guess the result? Let us first make sum as the global variable. Now the sum here has been made as global variable and has not been initialized to any value. So if you think the answer is again a garbage value, then it is wrong. Let us execute and find out. We observe that we again get the correct answer, which is 55, because the reason is that the global variables get initialized to 0 by default. I hope the concept of global variable is clearer to you now. So keeping in mind this fact, find out the output of this code. Probably you guessed the answer correctly. The output of this code would be 0. Let us execute and check. As expected, we get the answer to be 0. Can you tell the reason? Well, the reason is again based on the concept of global variable. Here, our global variable fact is declared and it gets initialized to 0. So, when this fact, which is initially assigned 0, gets multiplied by I in each step, the answer is again 0. Stay tuned and keep watching. For doubts, write in the comments section.